Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. See if we get some sleep in this noisy place. Without all being lost. I wish you could do something to help me rest. Why not, little sister? I run several hostelries and roadhouses in the real world. Perhaps it's enough if I... She shuts her eyes, and suddenly your eyes are forced shut as well. You aren't sleeping, but a warm calm floods your body, rejuvenating you as though you had slept in the finest inn in the Sega's protectorate. Is time still passing?
I can stand a little more of that.
There we go.
Cool. Thank you. Anything else to say? What can I do for the woman who rescued me from my greatest fear? Let's see if anything new. What can you make? Let's see what you can make again. Certainly. She doesn't have anything new. Now it's interesting. We can't sell stuff to her. Oh, he's using the galvanic hammer. Hold on. Actually, because I love this hammer he has, but... Cacophony blade, let's see. If any of these things are better, this is medium. Can he even use medium, heavy, and melee? So he's not... I mean, if there is a combat skill for medium... I don't even know. Alright. I'm only gonna give him heavy weapons. But yeah, we have this stuff. She gave it to us for free, so I took it. This is medium. This is a sapient blade, heavy melee weapon. Light range weapon, patronal, for perhaps for calisthenes. Exuvia armor, which isn't as good as I have. Right, two armor, three resistance, and 20% movement speed. Maybe this is better. Two and three. Did she sell us the Exuvia armor? I thought we actually had that before. I like the movement speed though. But this is good with the intellect pool. It's a step better in both armor and resistance. Well, that's a cloak. Never mind. Well, this is what we have. 4 armor, 6 resistance. Okay, okay. Never mind. This is cloak. I thought I was looking at the armor. Okay, yeah, this is better. Alright, let's go here. See. What about compare? Okay. They're both light ranged. That uses intellect. This uses speed. I hardly ever use her weapon anyway. But 10 mental damage, plus 2, to a max of plus 10. On hit, confers dazed. Critical hit, stunned. This is 12 energy damage, plus 3, to a max of plus 18. On hit, confer Patronal's fire. Yeah. I like the dazed effect on this, but... Let's use this. It hits a lot harder. How about that? How about it? Okay, so let's go to Aratisk. Okay, so his hammer is 13 physical, 13 damage, 13 energy to a max of plus 8. Critical hits only confers hobbled. With this. Okay, so we got 13 and 13 energy. 18 to a max of plus 15. On critical hits deals 8 mental damage. I'm not counting on critical hits that much. I mean, you can get critical hits kind of often sometimes, and sometimes you can go through a whole large battle without ever getting one. So I'm not even really going to count it. Unless it's freaking awesome, like, you know, I don't know, everyone in a radius just explodes or something, all enemies. So 18... This is better because it's 26. So yeah. The hammer is better. And now we have this. Sapient Blade. 10 physical damage to a max of plus 16. Plus 15% to critical hit chance, so increases critical hit chance. And on that critical hit, will gain Sapient Blade plus 5 mental damage. And the base stats are nowhere near as good as either of these, so no. This, however, is 10 and 10. This is 13, 13. Yeah, we're going to keep it like this. Alright. Sorry for the delay, guys. I'm pretty sure the middle one is where we want to go, the Village Fathom. It's the only place we haven't been besides here, the Path to the Resonance, which is our end goal. So,
yes, now.
Let's go. Now. I'm wondering if we'll find Rin in here, because she came from a village. The rug and jar are mundane, but not generic. This place was not built from your memories, but you know you've seen these before. Didn't they all have these little gods? Hers was a rock.
I'm ready. I'm always ready.
Matkina. Cool, Matkina. No, no, not Ning. It would take immense strength to create homes from these slabs of rock. You remember now, these are the homes of Koln Village. From the mirror Matkina gave you. Alright. That's another small area. You can tell by how much I'm covered already. Matkina! It's okay. It's an illusion. Damn, he's of the blackest hells, Paj. Matkina holds her weapons tightly and screams. As you come close, the shadows around her solidify. She is reliving the horrors of the attack on Koln. And for a moment you're there with her. The first militia lashes out with their weapons, and the villagers transform into their monstrous forms again. Her weapons have no effect, and her dying friends gout blood that washes around her boots. Neng, she thinks. Tick, I'm so sorry. I didn't know. The faces in her nightmare change and twist. You see the first's mask, Paj's face, Melmoth, the Memovira, countless faces, jeering, mocking, spilling their contempt across her. She fights savagely against the faces arrayed against her, each another stone in a wall of betrayal and mistrust. She's muttering and whimpering, as if caught in a living dream, and you could hear her whispers. Traitor. Murderer of dreams. Butcher. My fault. I'll scatter you. Burn you. I'm here, Matkina. You don't need to fight anymore. I'm here, Neng, she says. The shadows leer and twist around her, and a distorted vision of Paj's face looms in the air. She raises a flame lance high over her head and strikes swiftly. Matkina knocks it aside, plunging a knife in the shadow's body. The ferocious heat from the lance washes over you, even as the lance vanishes. This illusion is powerful, too powerful to just talk her out of it. In a whisper almost too soft to hear, you hear Matkina say, I don't want to fight anymore. Try to understand how you can help her. Her illusion is more powerful than it should be. She's aware of you, but just barely. What she needs is to stop fighting, and the only way she's going to do that is if she believes her enemies are dead. Perhaps you need to become one of her enemies. Huh. What if I shake her instead to snap her out of it? Come on, Metkina. It doesn't work. You put your hand on her shoulder to shove her, and she lashes out, quick as lightning. You snatch her hand away just in time. Come on, cowards, she screams. Come and fight. Come and die for what you've done. You reach out again, barely pulling away in time to avoid her blade. This isn't working. Her illusion is too strong. You sense the knowledge you need to help her is in a labyrinth somewhere, but not here in this fathom. I have the knowledge, don't I? Get close and let her kill you. Ow. You step forward. Well, it's only 4 damage. Arms outstretched. She sees you and attacks, driving her knife into your gut. She's too tortured to hit any vitals, but it still hurts. You come closer and put your arms around her. What? She blinks, noticing you for the first time. Tash? No. Who are you? She looks around at shades you can barely see. They're all dead. Tears well up in her eyes. All of them. I did this. If it weren't for me... These deaths are not your fault, Metkina. Gold. They're all my fault. I watched them die. I couldn't save them. And I never went back. And...
I'll remember that.
She is not looking at you. She's not talking to you. But then her head snaps back, and she sees you for the first time. What are you doing? Here. She steps out of your arms and quickly sheathes her weapon. By the Black Three, that's embarrassing. I suppose I owe you gratitude for getting me out of that. She thinks, the labyrinth. That's where we are, isn't it? I've dreamt of this place. You're my friend, Metkina. You don't owe me anything. More gold tied, more small amount. Her eyes widen for the briefest moment. I'll hold you to that, shall I? Forget about all about that pouch of shins I lifted off you earlier? All right. Got a plan in mind? Head up to the calm, if you can find a way. It's the center of this dream space. Split up and search the place? Good plan. If I don't see you again, farewell. And good luck. Okay, I suppose we'll meet her in the calm, and then we could talk to her and some more and stuff. Alright, not much to look at. We can't get behind this fence. Well, there's not much behind the fence.
Of course.
There is really not much here.
Ready.
These hovels are markedly different from the stone homes below, as if they were from a different village. Maybe they are. Hmm.
Happy to help.
Oh, I was hoping we'd find Rin. But we've already explored the whole place. Metkina? What about Allegern and Rin? Unless we'll find them in the resonance pathway, whatever.
Yes, now.
And what is this thing? You look up. The stone figure looks down, holding a circular symbol in its hands. Hair, or perhaps tendrils, curl from the edges of the hood that covers most of the statue's angular face. Abstract patterns race along the folds and wrinkles of the figure's robes. Examine the statue as a whole. If it's not immediately apparent who the statue portrayed... Oh, it's not immediately apparent, sorry, who the statue portrayed. Perhaps this was a major figure in another cast-off's life and found its way here somehow. You may never know. The symbol itself is a collection of shapes, a cross within a square inside a circle. You still have no idea who the statue portrays or how it came to be here. Touch the circle. You brush your hand against the circle and a vision enfolds you in its arms, showing you a ghostly woman's face, the same ghostly woman you met in the calm of your mind. Anguish fades from her, then the translucent light. Before long, her face is flesh once more. You release the circle, and the vision fades. Well, we can't touch the circle again. The cross, let's touch the square. I'm going inwards, if that means anything. You lay your hand upon the square, and a vision falls upon you, showing you a single figure kneeling at the peak of a jagged pile of bones. You cannot tell if it's a man or a woman, but the cast-off tattoo is clearly visible. All you can hear are the whispered words, "Thank you. Thank you. Thank you." You release the square and the vision fades. Touch the cross. You trace the cross with your finger and a vision cracks open your mind, showing you a billowing, towering creature, screaming with a thousand mouths. She is devouring herself. She is the Avenger, targeted for revenge, and she is dying. A billowing, towering creature. Couldn't be the Bloom, could it? Screaming with a thousand mouths. No idea what that's about. Pull the symbol free.
I think I'm ready to try something new.
Level up again. You lay both hands upon the symbol, pull, and a vision unfolds before your eyes. You tower over the world, crossing it with great invisible strides. Faces blur beneath you. A sea of them, but all of them have one thing in common. No cast-off tattoos. You and your siblings are nowhere to be seen. The image fades when you release the symbol firmly held in a statue's grip. Nonetheless, you still feel the rough edges of it on your palms, if only for a second. So I guess we can't get that. I thought it was going to be another, you know.
I'm going.
Oh, Rin, I wanted to find you. I mean, we found Matt Kena. She's not one that we currently had in our party.
In an instant.
Alright, back through.
Of course.
Let's see if we can talk to Matt Kena. Bring her in our party. That's her. Well, maybe because we have... that's Saria and Choi. Alright, let's level up Tiber before I forget. Yes. All we can do is increase edge. Increases might edge. Okay, we got abilities. We got resourceful. Cipher use now. Brawler. Ignore the flanked fiddle. Versatile effort. Plague spirits. Infuse critical hits with entropic forces conferring disrupted on top of the normal effects of the ability. Entropic forces destabilize the target, causing negative effects to increase each round. When you strike true, your enemies quail. The damage you do lasts beyond the moment, devouring your foe's energies from the inside. So far that one, but what's Virtuoso? Max effort plus +1 on all non-combat tasks. I'm going to take this. Virtuoso, actually. Oh, we can also increase a skill. Okay, we got a new tier, that's why. Ah. How about intimidation? There's been quite a few chances where intimidation would have helped had he, you know, not been completely untrained. This is untrained, or he's... Well, this will give him novice. This is inability, so let's train him one in intimidation. Yeah. See, he already has persuasion and deception. Give him that. Select a skill, you can only do one. Done. Alright, Makina, what say hast thou?
Changed your mind. Need some help.
You wanna join me again? Actually, wait. Best of luck to you, seriously. Just in case. Auto-save when we came back in here, but... I don't know what happens if we let someone go. They probably would just stay here, right? But since I'm not...
Changed your mind.
You want to join me again? She looks at the other companions and shakes her head. Too big a crowd for my tastes. Shake someone loose and ask again. Aye, Tiber.
Try not to think so hard. I think you're giving me an opinion.
Wait here for me. He shrugs. Why not? Maybe I'll have a wander through your mind. See what embarrassing secrets you keep under lock and key. He gives you a light salute. And then whistles.
Changed your mind. Need some help.
Instead of waiting around to die alone? Definitely. Let's see if she has anything to say. How are you holding up? Her eyes betray her impatience. Strong enough to make it to the end. I want to see this finished. She thinks, I don't know who or what is behind this, but if the first has any part of it, I'll make sure she pays. They'll stick for long enough. Probably. I can't ask specifically about different people. Talk about you again? Really? Nothing I say is going to make a difference now. Let's get this over with. We need to find our answers. Wait for you? She looks around and sighs. I guess this is your show. Even if I don't understand it, fine. Good luck. Ah, there you are. He folds his arms. Need me with you? Of course. He tips you a wink and falls in line. Let's get going. Daylight's waning, so to speak. Let's see if he has anything new to say here.
Try not to think so hard. I think you're giving me an idea.
Let's save the gossip for later, eh? Sees his face as calm, and she stares unblinkingly at you. I'm fine. We have other concerns. About the people we're traveling with. She shakes her head. The time for that is past. Whether for good or ill, they are with us. Now and perhaps for always. Just want to see what she says. You must make whatever decisions ensure your victory, dear. I'll be here if you need me.
Decided you need me after all.
As you wish, dear. Let's bring an end to all this. Eretus?
Tell me where to step. I want to kick over your memories.
Questions about you? Yeah. How are you holding up? Questions about the people we're traveling with. Let's talk about them when they're not all dead later. Wait for me here. Alright, just point me towards the part of your head with all the monsters you see in your nightmares. Wait, don't tell me. I'll find them myself if I get bored. And he giggles.
Bring me with you! Don't say no!
Come with me then. I knew you'd say yes.
Nothing can stop me now.
Onward, downward, and upward.
This is done.
Indeed. Now, how much am I down? Excuse me. I'm missing 4 points. I think I'll be alright. Do we have... Well, we have so many of these concentrated ones, actually. Oh, you know what? Give him 2. She's got a normal one. She's got 2. He has none. Give him 2 as well. Aratus, that is. We have 1 regular one. Let's see. She's full. 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 And I am almost full. Just in case. And because it only gives you... It heals 8 points of health, though. You know what? I am just going to save it for... A rainy day. Game's almost over, but 4 hit points? If it makes that much of a difference, I'll just reload. So next time, guys, tune back. We will head through the path to the resonance. Endure, and enduring, grow strong.